Okay, hi. I was scared. I just want to show you my Nikon one, this stuff, camera stuff. I was scared. I heard some rumors on the web saying that Nikon is going to discontinue its one series. I got scared because I invested a lot of money in Nikon one cameras and lenses. So I just want to show you that show that there is a market for Nikon one cameras and equipment, and the sensor size has a good demographic consumer base. So Nikon should not discontinue their Nikon one production. So let's see. So see, this is my Nikon one V1 camera. I bought it a long time back. I have not even updated the firmware. This is a Nikon one FT1 adapter, which allows you to put F mount lenses and DX mount lenses on the Nikon one camera. This is my DX Nikkor, Micro Nikkor 40mm AFS lens. I put it to the Nikon one camera. Then let's see. I have another Nikon one camera, V1 itself. This had problems with water moisture content. It had shut down twice, and this viewfinder tore, and it had sensor dust problem. So I'd given it to the Nikon one service center, and they this serviced it, and they removed the dust from the sensor. The viewfinder rubber has torn here, so that's a problem. The viewfinder rubber has torn, so I will just put sellotape on that. I've removed the side strips because they keep getting lost and falling down, so I just removed them, kept them safely. This is your HDMI out. This is your mini USB, and this is your mic in. This is my 10mm lens, 10mm f/2.8 lens, which is your Nikon one format lens, CX format. It works only on the Nikon one. So this remote works with the Nikon one also. It's a normal Nikon remote. I bought it long time back. I don't know the specifications. I've forgotten. This is your kit lens. This is your kit lens. What are you watching? Come sir. This is your Nikon one kit lens, 10-30. Your zoom kit lens, 10-30mm. I don't know, the aperture varies from, I don't know, from what to what, I've forgotten. But I rarely use this. Now my sister has bought a prime lens, 18.5mm, so we rarely use this. 10-30mm kit lens. And this has a problem, I think. The electrical contacts in between, when you zoom, I think they have been severed. So it is giving me black. So I think this is, I'll have to go and give this to repair. I don't know if the warranty is still applicable, but that's the situation on that. This is your 10-30mm. This I use the most with this, because in this focal length range, I don't have many lenses. All the lenses that I have are prime lenses, except for this one, but this is a 7-300mm f-mount, so equivalent is somewhere around 800mm. I use this for, but this has no autofocus, and this is a cheap, this lens, like 4000 or something I spent for this. Other than this, I use this. This is awesome. I use this for most of the sports stuff I shoot, and for videography, it's very good, because it meters, this meters only from the center, this center point. This has many metering points and autofocus points. This has only this. Only autofocus to the center of the lens. This is your lens hood. comes with this only. My 10 to 30 mm lens is giving me problems, but this is fine. Once, twice, there was moisture in this because of the rain and all, but the moisture went away, I don't know how. I didn't even put silica packets on it. This is another 10 to 30 mm lens which came with this camera, white one. I bought this camera off eBay. I don't for a bargain. There was a very good offer, and luckily I got it. I think I got it for around about 18,000. Yeah, fine. This is the lens. Same 10 to 30. This is working. This is not working. This is a problem with the electronic contacts. It's severed, I think, while zooming. It must have got severed, cut, and therefore it's showing me a black screen in this lens. I don't know what's the problem. I'll have to give it for repairs. This works. This is a prime lens, f mount, 1.8 aperture, 50 mm focal length. This I use it with the FT1 adapter, which is here. FT1 adapter. It's a manual lens, there's no autofocus for this. It gives you good shallow depth of field and good field of view. It's very good for portraiture and for kind of street videography. Means you can focus on the subject from a distance and without interrupting the scene. This is a nice lens. I like this lens a lot. And it's cheap also. I bought for 6,000 or something. I don't remember. But not more than 4 to 6. Yeah, this is this legacy lenses. This is Nikon F-mount lenses. This old one. I bought it off eBay. I don't remember why I bought it. I'm not using this a long time. But I don't know whether it is F1.8 or F1.2. But still, I'll find... Let's check. F1.4. Shit. It's one point. Aperture stops. This goes down to 1.4. This is for that shallow. It doesn't meter as well as this lens because there is support for this lens in the Nikon One firmware. I think. I don't know. These are technical things. I don't know so much. I've not done research. But I must have read about this lens, and it is F1.4. I must have got a good bargain, that's why I must have bought it. 50 mm lens. This is your... Yeah. Then... this is your M42 lens. And then I've got a M42 adapter to F-mount adapter, you can use that on the Nikon FT1 adapter. Lens was cheap on eBay, that's why I bought them. This has got nothing to do with Nikon One. But anyways, it looks... When you use it with the FT1 adapter, you can get really good stuff because the field of view changes. It goes very good for portraiture. The focal length of this is... I don't remember what it is. Where is it in here? Lens made in Japan at least. I don't remember where I've got it. I bought it with a reason, but I've forgotten. I've not used it since a long time. Forget, we'll get back to it. Here is it. 135 mm. F2.8. It's a 2.8 lens with focal length 135 mm. Vivitar. It's very good. I like this. I've taken few snaps with this. I found it when you use the crop factor of 2.7 and you multiply it by 135 mm, you get a good field of view and good focal length for portraits at least. And if you use it for videography, there's a look which you can't replicate with any other lens, which are currently available in Nikon One system. This is a thing I bought to attach my Nikon One system cameras to or a microscope. The microscope is there inside. I've not used it since a long time. Same problem. It's a 1/1/4 inch adapter, T adapter, made in China, Celestron. Usually with Celestron telescopes, but I wanted to use it for a microscope. Celestron makes many telescopes. It makes adapters so that you can connect your mirrorless cameras or other cameras. This is your, I don't know, this adapter is, I've forgotten. This adapter goes with F-mount lenses or your C-mount lenses. I'm not sure whether this is a... But I tried to use it with my microscope. I couldn't get enough sufficient light to fall on the sensor. So let's see. This is another project to do. This is another prime lens. Prime focal length lens. Fixed focal length lens. This is... I think this is... aperture, minimum aperture is 4. 4 and the focal length is... minimum aperture is 4. And means your maximum aperture, the widest aperture is 4. And focal length, I have not used this since a long time, years together, maybe 2 or 3 years. Meter. Where is it written? I think most likely this is 200 mm. It's a M42 lens, which is old. The flange distance of M42 is more than that of Nikon F-mount camera, so you can use it with an adapter. So if the flange distance is less, if I'm right, then you can't use it. The Nikon flange distance is lesser than the M42 flange distance, so you can use M42 lenses on the Nikon F-mount lens. I don't know whether, I don't know the this focal length of this is not written here, I can't remember also. I bought it long time back, 3 years back, I have not used it since. This is Gorilla Pod. While doing videos, it's your hands pain continuously, like 10 minutes, 12 minutes. So this, what I do is I put the camera on top of this and then I spread these things at least. And hold, you just rest this against your shoulder or your chin. And then you can, at least you can, without fatigue, you can hold the camera maybe for 15 minutes. And I stopped using my eye to to continuously videograph through the electronic viewfinder. You feel the fatigue in your eye because of the display of the, it's not an optical viewfinder. So I stopped using the electronic viewfinder for videography. For photography, it's okay. Maybe you'll be using the viewfinder just for maybe 3-4 seconds for each photograph. So this is the Joby Gorilla Pod. It's one of the best purchases I made. I use it the most. I use it a lot. Then what else? This is another old lens. I think this is 100 mm f4. Feet and meters are written here. I don't know. Even this I have not used. I don't know what the name of the lens also, because when I bought it, I've done Pentax. When I bought this lens, I knew for what I bought it, but I haven't used it since a long time. Maybe the occasion never presented itself. So these three lenses I have yet to use. But in the sense, I have yet to use them often. I've used them once, twice, but I should make it a point to use them even more.
Hey, can I put this?
It's going on, huh? Wait, no.
Wait.
Okay, then stop it. What?
You want to stop?
You're going to directly put it, huh? Running. How I'm doing? I don't know if this lens only, I've not removed and...
But the thing is, hold it a little more and show this thing, so I can show this one.
No, that we'll do in macro ray later on. Who's going to sit and show that? What is this? It fell down, my leather. Hello. Ready? It's run. So these are the batteries. They are. I think you can use them on the F-mount cameras also. FX cameras. FX cameras. I think they are in common. But I think now Nikon has changed the one series batteries, especially the new models J5 and the V3. They become a flat battery. This thing. I don't know the why they are doing it. Maybe to reduce the dimensions of the camera and make it more portable. This is a bulky battery. Now, Nikon One camera is capable of taking your 30 photographs within half, maybe, and burst mode, like you can take 30 photographs at the rate of 60 FPS. That gives you maybe 30 photographs in half second. Or buffer depth is sufficient for 30 photographs. So if you want the buffer to clear very fast, you need a very fast memory card. Now this memory card has a speed read or write speed, I'm not sure whether it's a read or write speed, of 95 mbps. So the faster the better, you'll be able to clear the buffer faster. Write speed, I think it's a write speed, I'm not sure. But this is first I had a memory card which was very slow, and every time you shoot a burst, it's to take forever to clear the buffer of the camera onto the memory card. So if you get a faster memory card, write speed memory card, you'll be able to clear the buffer fast. No other camera can shoot so burst mode as fast as the One series. Even though the resolution is less, but some applications you have like sports or something, where you need to shoot that many photographs in that small time interval. So I don't see why you should discontinue this camera. It has got a definite application scenario and a definite consumer base. So it would be foolishness on Nikon's part to discontinue this camera, especially this One system series. They can modularize it, like they can separate the LCD into a different module which is optional, like give clean HDMI out for video recording. And video recording facility in this camera is awesome, it's superb. Everyone says the same thing. That's why I bought these cameras, for video. That's the number one purpose. And they have filed for many patents. I don't think they will discontinue it, but it's scary if they discontinue. Because we can't afford to have full-frame cameras to do video recording, and that's especially 2-3 to shoot the same scene. It's just out of our budget. And what else is there? This is your 70-300mm, this is your AF Nikkor. It doesn't have autofocus, it is just a manual lens. This is if you have to zoom a lot, like 300 into 2.7 is what? Maybe 800 approximately, I don't know. Very poor in math. So if your subject is far away and you want a budget solution, caveat is you don't have autofocus in this, so you'll have to sit and manually focus with this thing, with this ring here. So if I want some snaps maybe in the middle of the football field, and if I want to zoom on someone's shoes or the ball, so this is the only thing I can afford. I cannot afford the autofocus 400mm f-mount lenses and all this, just out of individual photographer's budget, especially if you are financing your own self. You're not photographing for anyone and you don't have insurance and all that stuff. So what else is there?